Hello students, welcome back to physics class. Today I would like to discuss with you some problem related to electricity. Okay, here we have first problem: an electric lamp whose resistance is 20 ohm and a conductor of 4 ohm resistance are connected in series of 6 volt battery. Find the current through a circuit and potential difference across the electric lamp and conductor. Okay, so very first of all, let me go for given. Okay, see, so an electric lamp whose resistance is 20 ohm and a conductor of resistor, it is 4 ohm. So R1, we have, it is, we can say 20 ohm. R1 is 20 ohm, and R2 we have, they are given, it is, okay, 4 ohm. Okay, now, so once we have R1 and R2 are the what here, R1 is 20 and R2 is the what here, 4 ohm, are connected in series to a 6 volt battery, voltage is 6 volt. Okay, battery, find the current, we need to find current, I is equal to how much, and potential difference, PD. So potential difference across conductor and electric lamp. Okay, this is very simple. So we first of all, total resistance will be find. Total resistance RS is equal to, okay, these are connected in series, so this becomes R1 plus of R2. So now this is R1 is 20 plus of 4 is 24 ohm. Okay, now total resistance is how much here, 24 ohm. Okay, now I'll find current by using Ohm's law. So by using Ohm's law, okay, so that is V is equal to I into R. Okay, now V is equal to IR, Ohm's law. Now we need to find here I, so I can keep as it is. Now this becomes V by R. Okay, now V is how much we have, it is 6, and we have R is, now only we are finding it, this is 24, 6 ones are 6, 4s are, okay, 1 by 4, 0.25 ampere. Now, next we need to find potential difference across electric lamp, okay. So, PD across electric lamp, okay. So PD across electric lamp, so how we can find potential difference, okay, voltage we need across the what, electric lamp. So electric lamp resistance is 20, current we have this, so again V is equal to I into R. Okay, now V as it is, I is how much we have, so we have 0.25 into we have R, it is 20. So now this becomes 0.25 into 20. So how much we will get, it is, we can say 5 volt, okay, 5 volt, okay. So now next, PD across, next one conductor, next one we have conductor. So this in, again we have V is equal to I into R, so this becomes, we'll get here V is equal to, okay, I we already have 0.25 into R, how much we have across the what, we can say conductor, it is 4 ohm. Okay, now 4 ohm, 0.25 into 4 is 1 volt. Okay, so this is PD across the electric lamp, this is PD across the conductor. Okay, so this is very simple calculations, so I hope you understood very well. Well students, now we have here second question. Observe the given circuit diagram. Okay, so here they are given one circuit diagram. See, current they are given 24 volt, voltage they are given 24 volt, and they are given 5 ohm one resistor here, 4 ohm, 12 ohm. Okay, this is what the circuit here. What we need to calculate? Calculate the total resistance. Calculate the what? Total resistance and the total current flowing in the circuit. Total current flowing in the circuit. So we need to calculate here total resistance. Total resistance is how much and total current how much flowing in the circuit. So very first of all, so this implies, see here, these are in the parallel, okay, 4 ohm and the what, 12 ohm. So I'll consider this one, I'll take R1, this one I'll take R2, okay. Now, okay, so once I'm taken this one, so let me write, these are in the parallel, so 1 by RP, RP is nothing but what, resistance in parallel, okay. So 1 by R1 plus of 1 by R2, okay. Now this implies we have 1 by RP is equal to, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1, we how much we have, 1 by 4 plus 1 by 12, okay. So now again 1 by RP is equal to 4 and 12 LCM, we need to take 4 and we have 12 LCM, 4 1s are 4, 3s are 4, how much it is again, 12 will come, okay. 3 1 2 3, 3 into 1 is 3, 3 into 4 is 12 will come, okay. So now LCM will come 12, so this is how much are, we can say 4 3s are and this is 1s are, now 3 plus 1, okay. So 1 by RP is equal to, it is 4 by 12. Okay. So once it is a 4 by 12 means we have here C, so this will come 1 by RP is equal to 4 1s are 4, 3s are, so 1 by 3 will come, so RP is equal to 3 ohm, okay. So RP is equal to how much, 3 ohm. Now resistors in series, this is and this is, so look like what, in the same, so we need to calculate resistance in series. So first of all, now we'll calculate here, this implies RS, okay, RS we need to calculate now. So this is 5 ohm, this I'll take R3, okay, and plus RP, okay, so total is nothing but what, it is RP. So now this is R3 plus of RP, RP, okay. Now this is, we can say R 3 plus RP, because we are calculated already RP is 3. Now, so this becomes RS is equal to, okay. So resistors in series, so R3 is 3 ohm plus of, we can say it is RP, how much we have, R3 is we have 8 ohm and RP is we have 3 ohm, okay. So RP we have 3 ohm, this is RP 5 ohm, sorry, it is 5 ohm. Total RS is equal to 8 ohm, okay. So what we need to calculate, the total resistance, and this is what resistors RS, or can say that what here, to equivalent resistors. So total resistance here in this circuit is 8 ohm, okay. So this we can say that here, total RS is equal to 8 ohm. RS is nothing but what, this plus this. First you can do the this one, resistors are in the what, parallel, so we'll get RP is equal to 3 ohm. Once you got this much, now this plus this, okay, now this is R3 plus of RP, so 5 plus 3 is 8 ohm. This is the total resistors, okay, in the what, this circuit. Now here if you want means total, I'll write R equivalent resistors are nothing but what, we can say 8 ohm, okay. So this is total resistance in the what, circuit, okay. Now current flowing in the circuit we need to calculate, we know it very well, V is equal to I into R, okay. So we need I, so this becomes V by R, so this implies V, how much, see here, 24 volt we have, 24 volt, and total resistance is we have 8, 8 ones are, 8 threes are, so I is equal to how much, we can say 3 ampere, okay. So current flowing in this circuit is 3 ampere and the resistance in this total circuit is 8 ohm and current is 3 ampere. Okay, so I hope you understood very well. See, so these are what looking like in the same line. So this way you can take RS, that means resistors in series, and this are what looking like parallel. So parallel first you can calculate, then you can these two add, so you'll get RS. So this what the what total resistance, and apply the what Ohm's law, we know it V is equal to IR, so you'll get your current, okay, 3 ampere. Okay, well students, now we have your next problem. Observe the figure, just you can observe this figure here. See, 2 ohm, 4 ohm, 4 ohm resistors they are given here, 1 5 ohm resistor given, 6 volt battery given. So once these are things they are given here, calculate the total resistance in the circuit. Total resistance in the circuit we need to calculate, and the total current flowing in the circuit. Total current flowing in the circuit. So very first of all, this implies this is, we can take R1, I'll take this is R2, and I'll take this is R3. Okay, now just you can see here, R1, R2, R3 all are in the what, parallel. So 1 by, we know it formula, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus of 1 by R2 plus of 1 by R3. Okay, now this implies we have 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1. So R1 how much we have, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by R2 we have 4, 1 by 4, because this is also 4. Okay, now what is the LCM of this one? We need to take all the LCM, 2, 4, 4. Okay, so 2 ones are, 2 twos are, 2 twos are. Okay, now again 1 1 1, so LCM will come how much here? This is 2 into 2 is 4. Okay, so this will get 1 by RP is equal to total LCM is how much we'll get here, 4. Okay, now this is how much za, 2 2 za, this is 1 za, this is 1 za. Okay, now this is 2 plus 1 plus 1. Okay, now how much it is total will get here, RP. So now just you can see here, RP, this implies 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 4 by 4. Now this becomes 1, okay, ohm, 1 ohm. This is what regarding the what, 2 ohm, 4 ohm, and 4 ohm. Okay, so this is RP. Now here one more we have, so now this total plus this. Okay, so now again it is, I'll take equivalent resistance. Okay, 1 by R equivalent resistance, so 1 by RP plus, I'll take this one R4. Okay, 1 by R4. Okay, now this becomes 1 by R equivalent resistance, it is 1 by RP. So RP how much we have, it is 1 ohm plus. Okay, now 1 by R4, R4 how much we have, it is 5. Okay, so 5, so 1 by 1 means we'll get here, sorry, it is, we'll get 1 by 5. Okay, so LCM will come again, it is 1 by 1 means, okay, see, I'll write here. Okay, now this is 1 by R equivalent resistance, this is 1 plus 1 by 5, and this is 6 ohm. Okay, we'll get this is 6 ohm R equivalent. So otherwise we can say total resistance R equivalent is equal to 6 ohm. Okay, so once we return this, so we can say it is R equivalent is equal to 6 ohm resistance. Okay, now okay, this is 1 in 5, 5 plus 1 is 6 by, we'll get here total 5. Okay, so once we'll get reverse this one, so otherwise, okay, one total resistance we need to calculate. So RS, So these are in the what? Series R, 5U. So here we can't be write this one, okay? So now total resistance, okay? What I'll be do means this total resistance, total resistance is equal to, we have Rp is 1 ohm plus 5 ohm 6 ohm, okay? So total resistance is 6 ohm. Now next we need to calculate current. So I is equal to V by R. So I is equal to how much we have? So we have 6 volt, we have 6 volt, and total resistance we have, it is 6 volt. So current is equal to 1 volt, okay? So this is what we can say, 1 volt current in this total circuit is 1 volt and total resistance is 6 ohm, okay? I hope you understood very well. Well students, now we have here next problem. A bulb is marked 220 volt and 40 watt. Calculate the current flowing through the bulb and its resistance, okay? So first of all, we'll write here what they are given. So voltage they are given 220 volt and 40 watt, okay? P they are given 40, power they are given 40 watt. Calculate the current flowing through the bulb and its resistance. So we know that very well. What we know, P is equal to V square by R, okay? So we need to, its resistance, okay? First of all, we can convert this one. So we have R is equal to, this is V square by, we can say V square by P, okay? Now can substitute, it is V 220 square by 40. So what will be happens, it is, so 220 square, we can do it 220 square, okay? Now 0, 0, 0. Now this is, okay, again we have, see, 2 zeros are 0, 2 twos are, we have 4, and this is 2 twos are 4 into. Now 0, this is 2 twos are is 4, 4. Okay, now 0, 0 will come, this is 4 will come, 4, and this is 8, 4, 8, 4, double 0. Now, so we'll get here 4, 8, 4, double 0 by 40, okay? So once you got this, so 1, 0 and 1, 0 will cancel here. So remaining, how much will get here? So 4 is there here, 4 1 za, you will get 2 za, and this is 1 za 0, okay? So 1 2 1 0 ohm, okay? So this is what we can say R, okay? Once you got R, what we need to calculate? Current flowing through the bulb, okay? We need to calculate current. So we know it very well, I is equal to V by R. So I, V, how much we have? It is 220, and R resistance we have 1 2 1 0. So how much it will be happens, just you can see it is, we can simplify, you can simplify, you'll get this 0, this 0 will be cancel here. Now this is 1 2 1, and this is 2, can take 1 0 here extra because by keeping 0, okay? Now 1 to 1, and this is will be high, so 1s are only possible, 1 to 1 will come, so this is 0, 0, sorry, it is 1 will come, and this is again will get 1, 1 0 1 will be what here, remaining. So 1 0 1 will be remaining, means again we need to keep here, okay, we'll take here 1 0, so 1010 it is. So how much is 121? I think it's a possible. Okay, so it is 1210 will come. It's a is possible. Okay, something will come. So 0.18 ampere. Okay, so we can say the current flowing through the circuit is 0.18 ampere, and this is the what, resistance through the what, circuit. So I hope you understood very well. Okay. Now this is very simple. Power is equal to Power is equal to V square by R. Okay. And R we need to calculate. Transfer this R. P you can take it. P already they are given 40 watt. Okay. V already they are given. Square it. You will get this and make the what simplifications. Okay. So. Well, students, now we have your next question. An electric refrigerator rated 400 watt is used for 8 hours a day. An electric iron box rated 750 watt is used for 2 hours a day. Calculate the cost of using these appliances for 30 days. If the cost of 1 kilowatt is 3 RS, okay, 3 rupees. An electric refrigerator rated 400 watt is used for 8 hours, okay. Energy consumed for, we can say energy of one day. So here energy of one day, okay. So we can say it is power into time. So this is power is how much here? 400 into 8. Okay, so how much hours it is? 8 hours. So this becomes how much we'll get? 4 into 8, 32. Okay, so 3200. Okay, so we need to convert in kilowatt. So this becomes 3.2 kWh. Okay, so this is for one day. Now for 30 days. So 3.2 into 30, so 96, okay. So this is what 96 for 30 day. So 96 kWh, okay. Now once you got this one, for this if the cost of 1 kilowatt hour per hour is 30, then we can say 96 into it is 3, so rupees how much? Rupees we need to calculate, rupees 288. So this is for the what? Refrigerator. Now for we can say iron box, okay. So it is energy for one day, it is 750 into again how many hours it is? 2 hours. So 750 into 2 is we have 1500. Now this is 1.5 kWh, okay. Now this is for one day. So now next for 30 days, so we can write this is 1.5 into 30, so it is 45. Okay, so this is 45 kWh kilowatt per hours, okay, correct. So 45 kilowatt hours. Now for we can say rupees, okay. Now 3 we have, this implies 45 into 3, so 135 rupees, okay. 135 rupees. This is very simple. We can use this formula, power into time. So once you got means you can convert this into what? Kilowatt hours per hours. Once you converted this one, so go for the what? Converting for 30 days, then into 3. Okay. Similarly here also. So this problem is very easy. Okay. I hope you understood.